But if you're also heading out, there's a chance you may want to look up to the sky because you might catch a glimpse of the so-called zombie star, even though it's about 3,000 light years from Earth. It is a rare phenomenon, and who better to discuss than with a NASA scientist? So let's bring in Dr. Elizabeth Hayes. Dr. Hayes, good to have you here this afternoon for us. I was today years old when I found out, I was doing some research on this, that stars actually are born, live, and die. So how did the zombie star get its name?
Right. So it's a zombie, but you don't have to be afraid of it. It's not coming to eat your brains. It's actually a dead star that has a companion nearby, and that companion is feeding it. It's eating the material in the sense that it goes all around the star, and even though it's a dead star and not burning like our sun does, it can then reach the point where it has a flash of brief light that comes out in an explosion that we can actually see that makes it look like a new star. So then in that sense, it kind of comes to life again, sort of like a zombie.
And this only happens once every 80 years?
For this system. And that's actually really rare. There are only a few that happen, you know, we see them multiple times in sort of a human lifespan. This one happened before 80 years ago, so we kind of knew what to look for, and we're, you know, seeing now the signs that it's ready to explode. So we're really excited to go and get this close-up view. It's not very far away, so the show's going to be spectacular for all of the astronomers who are watching, and hopefully for some people on the ground, too.
And let's talk about the timing of this. Like, what's the best time, I guess, we should be looking up at the sky? And is there any special equipment or anything that we need?
So when this nova actually happens, you won't need special equipment for a couple days. It'll be almost as bright as the stars in the Big Dipper. Now, you want to look for its constellation. It's going to happen near the constellation Coronae Borealis. That's the Northern Crown. And right now, you can see that constellation after sunset in the western sky. So it's a good time to get familiar with that part of the sky before it changes.
And I wanted to ask you, what do scientists hope to learn from this particular phenomenon, with it being so rare?
Well, we'd really like to know, like, how quickly is our zombie star eating? How quickly is it gathering this material? And what actually happens just before this eruption goes off? We don't get too many chances to see this. And we have just amazing eyes on the sky here at NASA and on the ground that are going to get this spectacular view. And so you can see here where the object's going to appear next to Coronae Borealis. It's going to look like a new star. And at the same time, our telescopes at NASA are going to be gathering like this really precise data about how fast is the material moving when it goes out. What happens when these stars die? There are actually lots of zombie stars, very few that we get to see like this. And we want to understand them so we know how our solar system formed.
All right. Dr. Elizabeth Hayes from NASA, good to talk to you here this afternoon. Thank you for your expertise and insight.